Hello, I'm Simoncat. The game we're talking about today is the story of someone who was so depressed he opened a forbidden book of prophecy in order to destroy all dimensions. The only people who can stop the prophecy are four heroes. Now, what if I told you those four heroes were Mario, Luigi, Peach, and Bowser?
Super Paper Mario released on the Wii in 2007. I imagine most people's first impressions of this game were, oh cool, a new Paper Mario. There's no turn-based combat. Super Paper Mario is considered by most to be a mixed bag. A game that has some good elements, but isn't as good as the first two.
And they're right.
Super Paper Mario drops turn-based combat in favor of being a 2D platformer. It's safe to say this was a pretty controversial decision. So it's a 2D platformer now. Big deal. I would be fine with this game being a 2D platformer if it took a familiar Mario-like approach to the level design, but instead the level design is more puzzle-oriented. Not that even that is inherently bad. I'll list off every example of maze-like, repetitive, and hopelessly obtuse level design. Chapter 2-4 is a maze where doors take you wherever they feel like. On my first playthrough, it took me over 30 minutes to find the exit. Chapter 4-1 has the same problem. Chapter 5-1 has you say please to this guy 5 times before he tells you a code so long you have to write it down. I assume this was supposed to be funny, but it's just annoying. Chapter 7-2 has a large set of platforms you have to jump up for what seems like a minute with no variety. And Chapter 8-4 has a maze that's very easy to get lost in. Ironically, the challenge right before the final boss being a maze perfectly fits this game, because the hardest challenges in this game so far have all been mazes. In short, Super Paper Mario is the lost levels of puzzle platformers. Let's talk about the main selling point of the game according to the marketing, switching to 3D. At first it sounds like a pretty neat feature, finding secrets and solving puzzles by switching to 3D. But then you realize it has a time limit. If you spend too much time in 3D, you take damage.
Ahem.
Why?
Along with that, switching to 3D is the solution to half the game's puzzles. Replacing partners from the first two games are multiple playable characters, being Mario, Peach, Bowser, and Luigi. Only Mario can switch to 3D, which is kinda annoying. Peach can glide with her parasol, Bowser can breathe fire, and Luigi can jump high. Once you get Bowser, most enemies become a joke because you can just breathe fire on everything in your path. Speaking of fighting enemies, you still get XP for taking them out. Leveling up only upgrades your HP and attack, and you can't choose which, it just upgrades in a set order. So if the gameplay is this mediocre, why do I and so many other people consider this game to be so good? You play it for the story. Mario and Luigi are told Peach is nowhere to be found in a castle, which must mean Bowser took her, right? So Mario and Luigi go to Bowser's castle only to find out that Bowser is just now planning his attack, and Peach has already been captured by Count Bleck. Count Bleck then captures Luigi, Bowser, and all his minions. The reason Count Bleck needs Peach and Bowser is to have them get married in order to summon the Chaos Heart, which creates the Void, and the Void will eventually destroy all dimensions. A pixel named Tippy brings Mario to the dimension in between dimensions, Flipside. So it's up to Mario to find the 8 pure hearts and reunite with Peach, Luigi, and Bowser to become the 4 prophesied heroes. The story may sound pretty normal for Paper Mario standards so far, but it gets incredible the more you progress through the game. I hesitate to call it the best Mario story ever told, because the Mario and Luigi games do a better job developing the main Mario cast, but it is still amazing for what it's worth. The story has so many moving parts that it's hard to keep track of them all, in a Mario game. So now we must ask ourselves, what makes a good Paper Mario game? In my opinion, in order for a Paper Mario game to be good, it must have at least half of these traits. Unique locations, a deep story, well-written characters, and an engaging battle system. Sticker Star laughs in the face of that and has none of them, but Super Paper Mario has all but one, the engaging battle system. Super Paper Mario has most of what makes a good Paper Mario game, so therefore, Super Paper Mario is a good game worthy of standing alongside its predecessors. At least it is when you look at my very logical list of things that make a good Paper Mario game. Something else I want to mention is the character design. Although every character is well written, their designs aren't that great. Let's compare original character designs from Thousand Year Door and Super Paper Mario. I get that these are multiple different dimensions and not just the Mushroom Kingdom, but did the characters really have to have these weird blocky designs? Chapter 1 is yet again pretty basic. Some things never change. Chapter 2 seems like another basic chapter until you're forced into manual labor. Super Paper Mario is subverting player expectations the game. The most well-known example of subverting player expectations in Thousand Year Door was Chapter 4, but Super Paper Mario takes it to the extreme. Chapter 4 takes place in outer space. This is where you meet Mr. L for the first time. In what other Mario game would you fight a brainwashed Luigi? Chapter 6 seems normal until the world just gives up and gets deleted. Up to this point, the void in the background was just a constant reminder of your goal, which is to save all worlds from destruction. And by the end of Chapter 5, you're sure you'll be able to do it before the void actually consumes any worlds. The door that leads to the world that just got deleted still exists, so you go through. It can't be that bad, right? What? This is the fate of all worlds if you don't succeed. It's one of the most important moments in the whole game. In any other game, you would save the world before someone deletes it, not after. Then shortly after exploring the world of nothing, Mario dies. Because Mario is, well, dead, he gets to experience Dante's Inferno firsthand. I know I've already said this before, but
in what other Mario game?
The final chapter and the ending are so good that I won't spoil them in this video, but feel free to discuss them in the comments. I might even make a short follow-up video discussing the ending. Super Paper Mario is the Paper Mario series at its most creative and most story-driven. The gameplay is sometimes fun and sometimes say please to this guy 5 times. But Super Paper Mario, of all games, is the pinnacle of Paper Mario storytelling. Super Paper Mario is a mediocre must-play.
Well, Super Paper Mario is a good experiment, but for the next Paper Mario, I hope we get the best aspects of all the Paper Mario games combined into one. Wait, do you hear that? It sounds like impending doom. Ah!